For over 13 years, Friends of Children Boston has been committed to breaking the cycle of generational poverty by forming professional mentoring relationships with children facing the highest risks, starting from kindergarten and lasting through high school graduation. On June 29th, Friends of the Children Boston hosted the 2017 Achievers Entrepreneur Business Plan Competition, an event made where 25 middle and high school youths from Dorchester, Roxbury, and Mattapan presented pitches for innovative business plans that would have a positive impact on their communities. Here to share more about the event and the organization is Yi-Chin Chen, Executive Director at the Friends of the Children Boston. Also joining us to tell us about her team's winning business plan is Achiever Business Plan Competition winner, Jendai Williams. Thank you both for coming in and welcome to Urban Update. Wow, this is really something. Yi-Chin, let me start with you. Can you sort of just tell our viewers about the mission of your organization, Friends of the Children Boston?
Sure, absolutely. Just like you said, Friends of the Children Boston is a very unique model. Our mission is to break the cycle of poverty and create generational change for children who are considered to be most vulnerable in our city. The way that we do that is we select children at a very young age who are facing significant barriers like homelessness or instabilities at home or significant barriers to learning, and then we pair them up with professional salary mentors and we commit to them to supporting them from kindergarten all the way through high school graduation.
Okay, now you recently held your Achievers Entrepreneur and Business Plan Competition in Boston. Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Absolutely. So more than a year ago, we had this idea. As our achievers grow older, all of them are thinking about what their next step is going to be in life, and many of them have an interest in starting their own businesses. And so we actually was very fortunate to be able to form a partnership with Santander Bank to pilot a entrepreneurship program where young people in middle and high school are in teams and get to actually design a business plan to present in front of judges. And so at the end, we have 25 achievers and broken down into six teams, and they all went before the judges on June 24th, and it was a fantastic day. They all did a fantastic job.
Wow, amazing. Now, Jendai, let me turn to you. Congratulations on winning, first of all. Your business plan, this is for the Grub It Up food truck, mm-hmm. which won a $2,500 grand prize. Tell me how you came up with the idea and you developed this.
Well, thank you, first of all. And we end up researching communities and their needs and the existing businesses. And we realized that, particularly in certain areas, that there's a lack of Caribbean and soul food places. And there's a lot of increase in Caribbean and African American backgrounds. And we did a lot of logos, startup budget, the sales strategies, and even Santander volunteers helped us with everything. And we eventually presented it to the five judges.
Wow, and so you did all that research to find out where this need was there.
Yeah.
Wow, amazing. Now, why was it important in your view to create a business plan that also benefited the community?
Well, what's the point of starting a business without a business to actually create? What's the point of starting a business that is not going to benefit the community? Mm-hmm. You need a business, and there's a lot of business out there, but our business will be so special that people not only going to buy our stuff, but also benefit from us. We want to input something in the community, not just create a business to get profit.
Okay, all right. Now, Yi-Chin, talk to me about, I guess, what's on the horizon for your organization, Friends of the Children Boston.
Sure, yeah. We just took on 12 brand new achievers who are kindergartners. We're growing. Yes,
wow.
They're going into first grade, so we're very excited to have the little ones running around in our office again. And our commitment, again, is to follow them for 12 and a half years from kindergarten all the way through high school graduation. We're also gearing up for the second year of the entrepreneurship program, which will kick off in September with another group of 25 achievers who are in middle and high school. So there's a lot of exciting things. It's all about growth and about creating really positive impact on the lives of young people who often don't have these opportunities.
That's amazing that you have these kids. You start them at the young age and you sort of you guide them all the way up through high school. I mean, how do you find these kids? How do you identify them? How are you able to get them to stick with this the whole time?
Yeah, that's a great question. We identify them by actually sitting in their kindergarten classroom for more than 100 hours.
Wow.
We do 100 hours of observations, really looking at children in all settings. What we're looking for are children who have a great amount of potentials, but are exhibiting behaviors that are going to become barriers for success later. And then we partner with the families. The families are a huge part of the work that we do. We partner with them because oftentimes they're very overwhelmed with everything else that's going on in their lives, and we really become their partners to support them all the way through.
Jende, I guess, talk to me about the next steps for the Grub It Up food truck. What are the next steps? And first of all, where are you located? Do you stay in one spot? Do you move around?
Well, our startup location is Quincy, due to the fact that, again, there's an increase of African American and Caribbean backgrounds, and actually no places that cater to any of their needs. So that's what we wanted to target first. Mm-hmm. And the next steps for the Grub It Up food truck is, well, we have a lot of contacts, including the Commonwealth Kitchen of Boston, I believe, mm-hmm. and a lot of tours, different areas, donation organizations that would want to contribute to helping us start up for our Grub It Up food truck.
One of your favorite dishes, or maybe that I might try when I...
Well, I recommend the curry chicken,
okay,
oxtail, rice and peas.
All right.
That's good.
Okay, that's what I learned when I get to your truck. That's just what I'll order. Yi-Chen, before we go, it's just a little bit about your own personal journey. Just talk to me about a little bit how and when you arrived in Boston.
Sure. It's an interesting story. I was actually born and raised in the southern city of Kaohsiung in Taiwan. Had a lot of challenges at home when I was growing up, and actually left home when I was 16 years old to pursue better opportunities, and ended up in the United States, and became a social worker at the end, and have been a youth worker and a social worker for more than 15 years. I couldn't have made it to where I am today without the mentors really supporting me along the way and making sure that I have everything that I need to succeed. So this mission is very dear to my heart.
Yeah, I was going to say, so if you remember what it was like to have a mentor.
Absolutely.
And to need a mentor, so you're turning around and giving back, and that's sort of sounds like that's what's giving you the inspiration to work with these kids and mentor them.
Absolutely. I see a lot of myself in young people like Jandea, and a lot of the times what people see are the challenges you have. They don't see the potentials that you have, and so what we really try to do with Friends of the Children Boston is to remove those barriers and remove those labels so people get to see how bright they are and how much potential they have.
Jandea, any words about the organization, or what Yi-Chen has done, what the folks have done, how they've helped you at all?
Yes, big thank you to the Santander volunteers. They really helped out and put extra time forward. Another thank you to Yi-Chen, Marie, my mentor Keisha. She's the one that led the team. Without her, we wouldn't have gotten everything exactly organized. Friends of the Children really established a lot of opportunities for us, and really realize that businesses are hard to create.
Right. Okay. Well, now you know. So your next one is going to be a killer, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Jende I. Williams and Yi-Chen Chen, thank you both for coming in.
Thank you.
Congratulations to you, and congratulations to you on doing such a great job with these kids, and good luck.
Thank you very
All right.
much.
Okay.
Thanks, Byron.
Coming up next, an animal rights advocate working on getting legislation passed, and she's also working on getting promoted to the fifth grade. All the details right here on Urban Update.